Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over hyperlinks. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. I am going to show you three different kinds of hyperlinks. The first one will be your standard hyperlink to a website. The second one will be an email hyperlink that will automatically open up your email program and let you start an email. And the third one will be on your phone with a phone number link to allow you to make a phone call just by clicking on the link in the mobile version of Excel. We have a practice file available in the description below if you would like to follow along with us. So today I'm going to be using the online version of Microsoft Excel on office.com. And let's create one instance of each of these types of hyperlinks. The first one will be website, the next one will be email, and the last one will be phone number. And the website one is really simple. So I'm just going to go to our blog and I'm going to highlight the link up here in the address bar and right click and go to copy. And then I'm going to go back to Excel and right click here and just paste. Now, if I expand this column, I can see that there's some text here that's more descriptive of my link. So I may or may not want that text on here. That's up to you. But first of all, let's just test that our hyperlink works. If I click on this link, I will be brought to our blog. So I know that that link is working. So let's look at a few properties of that link. If I right click, I can go down here to edit hyperlink. And I have a few options here. You can see that this is the display text. I could make that display text just the link to the website and hit OK. And now you will see instead of a more user-friendly name, you can see that this has been turned back into the full address. But if I right click on that again and go back to edit hyperlink, I can change that display text back to my Excel online blog. And down here, it asks, where would I like to link to? And this is where you would put the link to the actual website in here. And then I'm just going to say, okay. And you can see now that it says my Excel online blog. If I don't want this to be a hyperlink anymore, I can right click and go to remove hyperlink. And you can see when I do that, that the text that was originally in the cell is what's kept, not the web address. But if I wanted to just insert a hyperlink from here, I could right click and go to hyperlink. And here I could just paste back in the address for my website. And then my hyperlink will be working again. So right click, remove, or right click and edit. You can also right click and open the hyperlink, and what that will do is that will take you directly to that link online. One more thing I want to show you is if you hover over the hyperlink, if you've used a more user-friendly name, it will tell you where that hyperlink is going to go. And it also says click once to follow, or click and hold to select this cell. So you've seen me click and follow, but if I click and hold the mouse button down, I can actually select the cell and move it all around Excel. So that's by clicking and holding, in case you need to do that.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
Okay, so our next type of hyperlink is an email address. So let's just say I would like to email info@microsoft.com. Now watch, once I hit enter, you can see that that has been automatically created as a hyperlink. So if I click on that, I will launch Microsoft Outlook, and you can see that an email is all ready to go. So let's close that and go back to Excel. So how is this link as an email different from the link above? Well, if I right click and go to Edit Hyperlink. You can see that the email appears in the third option down here because Excel will know this is an email type link when it appears down here in this third option. This one up here is for websites. This one right here is for a particular location on your Excel spreadsheet. And this one down here is for email. So if I say OK, and if I right click on an empty cell and go to hyperlink, you can see down here that in gray, it does say email address right here. So I'm going to cancel out of there. So for the next one, we have how to create a phone number hyperlink. And if I spell out T-E-L with a colon and then type in a phone number and hit enter, Excel also knows that this is a hyperlink. But if I click on this on my computer, I don't have any calling software on my computer, so it's not going to help me. So I'm going to show you what this looks like on your phone. But before I do that, I just want to right click and go to Edit Hyperlink. And you can see the T-E-L with the colon in front of it in the hyperlink section. And so I'm going to say OK. So now let's see what the phone number looks like on the mobile version of my phone. So because my file is in OneDrive, I can bring up this same Excel file on my mobile version of Microsoft Excel. So now what I'm going to do is in the phone number field, when I click on it, I get this option up here called link, and I'm just going to click the link and say open. And you can see that my phone now wants to call the phone number that is in that cell. So if I were to click that, I could see that my phone will start dialing. Also in the phone number, if you have a cell over here that just has a phone number, if I click in another cell, I can use what's called the hyperlink function. So if I just went equals hyperlink with a left parenthesis, let's say in this case, I want to use the tell with the colon in front of it in double quotes, and I use an ampersand, I can click on here. And if I close my parentheses and hit enter, it will now create whatever is in this cell into a hyperlink. So if I change that phone number, it changes it here automatically with the three on the end. Also, if I look at this formula right here, and I go back after my first argument, I can also put a friendly name in there. So let's say, call me. And if I hit enter, you can see the friendly name of the link is now Call Me. So hopefully that's enough to get you started on learning how to use hyperlinks inside of Microsoft Excel. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.